Now to a neighborhood crime alert on the West Side. New information about a drive-by shooting that put a 10-year-old Jacksonville boy in the hospital. We're learning how it all unfolded last Friday night. Police are asking for your help tracking down the person who fired the shots. News 4 Jax reporter Ethan Calloway is joining us live from UF Health in Springfield with an update on how the child is doing. Ethan?
And we stopped by that house today, Tom. Someone did come to the door, not having much to say, only telling me that 10-year-old is recovering, doing much better, and talking with family members here at the hospital. Still, as he recovers, police are trying to find the person who shot him. A Friday night in this usually quiet West Side neighborhood turning violent. Police say someone in a passing car shot at this house at least twice, with bullets hitting a car out front and the house itself. That bullet punctured this front window, hitting a 10-year-old boy inside playing video games with his sister.
I think that the 10-year-old being shot is crazy. That's like awful.
Simone Bridges is 12 years old and lives just blocks away.
I feel comfortable coming out here and playing with my family and my friends, but now I have to think twice because of that.
The newly obtained police report explains the boy's father was sitting in the living room with his wife when he heard a loud popping sound. Immediately after, he heard his son Elijah Williams screaming from his bedroom. The report shows Elijah suffered a gunshot wound to his abdomen. Investigators later found three shell casings in front of that home. The shooting rattling this neighborhood filled with children.
I wouldn't want to let anybody younger than me to go through that experience, not even anybody older than me. But for that, like, that person needs to really think about what they've done and go back and probably apologize, do something, turn themselves in.
Again, that little boy is expected to recover. Police are still looking for the person who shot him. No vehicle description or suspect description has been released at this point, but they're asking anyone with information on who may have been involved to give them a call. We're live in Springfield. I'm Ethan Calloway, Channel 4, the local station.